Disclaimer, the following was shot after the viewing of Q-Rangers finale and before the viewing of Lupin vs. Pato episode 1. Tomorrow, thoughts on Lupin vs. Pato will be included in a special video. Enjoy!
Hello everyone, it's Thomas Jujubee. I just saw the finale of Q-Ranger and I'm here to give my thoughts on the entire series. So, let's just get this right out of the way. I enjoyed Q-Ranger. Sure, it had its rough spots here and there, but I don't think I ever hated Q-Ranger at any point. I greatly enjoyed this season. Plot-wise, the series was pretty cool because the good guys already lost. The villains had already won and we had to defeat them to, well, take the universe back. Although, I wish we would have seen more planet hopping because of that, since we were really milking that space aesthetic, I'm glad that we still did it enough times that you could remember it. I like that because we had this big evil organization in charge of the universe, there were multiple bosses within it that the Q-Rangers had to take down. It really felt like it was this massive empire that had different tiers of leadership and power. Visually, Q-Ranger was awesome. I loved all of the suits, mechas, and weapons that were presented to us, and it was even cooler seeing all of them in action. I really hope that they are brought over to America. This series also has the largest team in Super Sentai and Power Rangers history, coming in with 12 different Rangers. People were worried that they wouldn't be able to balance, all of them, and while that did happen to some degree, it wasn't terrible. Some got more development and focus than others, but I think that everyone got some development, as small as it might be. Along with that, I didn't hate anyone. Sure, Lucky was annoying at first, but as they developed him, toned him down, as we spent more time with him, I began to find him less and less annoying. And hey, now he's one of my favorite Q-Rangers. Of course, Q-Ranger wasn't perfect, nothing is. Like I said, I feel like we gave a lot of spotlight to certain characters and not a lot to others. For example, we don't know how Hammy, Champ, or Spada gained their Q-Tamas and joined the Rebellion. We kind of forgot about Kotaro's little brother and the fact that Garou lost his entire planet. We also have some weird filler, something worse than it in my opinion. With normal filler, you can just skip to the next episode and you won't be affected at all. The plot goes on. With this Q filler, you can't skip it, because then you're missing an important plot point that was haphazardly thrown in. Of course, they do fix that, I guess, by adding a focus to a certain character in the episode, so I mean it really depends. However, I think Q-Ranger's biggest problem was its runtime. Q-Ranger ran alongside Kamen Rider X8 and Kamen Rider Build for Superhero Time, and they were two fantastic rider series. This meant, to me at least, that it was overshadowed most of the time and wasn't able to truly shine. I found myself looking more forward to X8 than Q-Ranger because I personally like X8 more. And that's a shame because Q-Ranger was not terrible, it was just really overshadowed. But as I said, I really enjoyed my time watching Uchu Sentai Q-Ranger, and I believe it will go down as one of my favorite Sentais. Also, the results of the Q poll was top 10 characters in first place with 53% of the vote, and top 10 Voyagers in second place with 34% of the vote. Look forward to seeing those in the coming weeks. And as always, let me know down below in the comments what you thought of Q-Ranger and if you hated it, loved it, or somewhere in between. I'll see you next time, and remember, Yoshalaki!